Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have a biology form 2 lesson 21. We are going whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on gaseous exchange and the subtopic gaseous exchange in the tracheal system of an insect. But before we go deep into the gaseous exchange in the tracheal system, we shall generally look at the gaseous at the general gaseous exchange in insects. We're going to have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson you should be able to describe the gaseous exchange in insects. And I've said that I'm going to give a brief description of the gaseous exchange in generally in insects, whereby insects, we know they are generally small animals. The small size is quite advantageous to the animals in terms of gaseous exchange, since their surface area to volume ratio is large. However, being larger than organisms like the protozoans, whereby we can get an example of the protozoan as the amoeba, there is need for the development of a breathing system. This system is made up of large network of air tubes, which are known as the tracheal system. The system penetrates into all parts of the body to improve on the efficiency of the gaseous exchange. The tracheal system of an insect, which forms its breathing system, consists of the spiracles, the trachea, and the tracheals. The spiracles are external openings present on either side of the abdomen and thorax of an insect, through which air from the atmosphere enters the body. I'm going to show you a diagram, whereby it is showing the position of the tracheal of the tracheal gills of an insect. So we are saying that these are the breathing structures of an insect, which are mainly the trachea. So these are the breathing structures. We are saying that the spiracles, the external openings present on either side of the abdomen and thorax of an insect, through which air from the atmosphere enters the body. Each spiracle is supplied with a muscular valve that controls its opening, and also with airs to prevent excessive loss of water from the body tissues by evaporation. The spiracles then open into large tubes, which are known as the trachea, which are arranged in definite patterns, as you can see from our diagram, and they penetrate the whole body of an insect. These air tubes are reinforced with spiral bands of chitin to keep them open. Having that, now we can go into the gaseous exchange in the tracheal system of an insect. Now we are going to look at how a gaseous exchange takes place in an insect. We say air is drawn into and out of the tracheal system by muscular movement of abdominal wall. We can show the abdominal wall, whereby we are going to have an example of a certain diagram representing a mosquito larva. In wasps and bees, abdominal segments are moved in and out lengthwise, while in locusts and cockroaches, the segments are moved laterally. When spiracle valves are open, air is drawn into the tracheal system. After that, the valves close and air is forced along the system by muscle movements. Oxygen diffusion into the watery fluid in the tracheals and into the cells due to higher oxygen diffusion gradient. Likewise, carbon 4 oxide diffuses out of the tissue cells and into the fluid, then into the tracheal system due to carbon 4 oxide diffusion gradient. I'm trying to explain the diagram that we are seeing on our screen. The thoracic spiracle valves close as the abdominal spiracle valves open, and the gas is released through the spiracle openings in the abdomen of the insect. Insects which live in water also carry out gaseous exchange inside the water. We have an example of insects like the dragonfly, whereby they use tracheal gills that as seen in our diagram here. They use the tracheal gills as seen in the diagram on our screens. However, most of the aquatic insects have an elaborate tracheal system and are not truly aquatic, because they need to come to the surface to breathe. For example, we have the mosquito larva, which is being represented here on our screen. We have the mosquito larva, which have spiracles near the rectum on a tube called a respiratory siphon. Sorry. The siphon is opened when the larva comes to the surface of the water to take in air, and is used by valves when the larva submerges. The larva comes to the surface of water periodically to breathe and position themselves. In the pupa stage, a pair of zippons open just behind the head. They pierce through the water surface to allow for gaseous exchange. However, some adult insects like the water beetles or what we call water bugs, they use bubbles of air trapped by hairs or other structures on their body surfaces. The air bubbles give these insects a silvery appearance. However, other insects, they use a respiratory device known as the plastron for gaseous exchange. The plastron, just to mention, is a pile of very fine and washable hairs which cover the cuticle for some distance around the spiracle to hold off water and also to maintain a layer of air over the body surface. What we are seeing here is the mosquito larva, whereby we can see it. We have got the eye, we have now the tubes, which are used they are used for the purposes of respiration. We have also the cephalothorax. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity, whereby you are required to explain the mechanism of gaseous exchange in the tracheal system. And especially here, because we have dealt with an insect, you can explain the gaseous exchange in the tracheal system of an insect. For more information about this lesson and others, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 1, which is 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS to the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us an message on our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _ Kenya. Thank you. Let us subscribe so that we get more of these lessons. You are welcome.